One of the advantages to having a programmable ignition is the ability to alter ignition timing or set up an ignition curve for your specific application. But why do you need an ignition curve? Even back in the days of breaker points and distributors, engineers recognized the need to be able to alter the ignition timing as RPM and load conditions change. To accomplish this, distributors were made with a mechanical advance mechanism that operated through centrifugal force. These advanced assemblies featured weights, springs, and in some aftermarket distributors, an advanced stop. As engine RPM increases, the weights are pushed out as they overcome the tension of the springs. This is how the rate of advance would be determined. Racers would tune their distributors with different springs and weights to achieve their desired ignition curve. But we're in the 21st century, and now racers can accomplish things with digital technology that were never before possible with mechanical advance assemblies. Let's take a look at how you can set up a timing curve with your programmable 7 ignition control.
Let's program a timing curve. Find your gear retard curve map at the bottom. Make that large. At the right hand, you'll find degrees of timing versus RPM. Open up your trace analysis box. In this box, you'll find that you can program a different timing curve up to 6 gears. In our case, we're going to use a 3-speed. The example I'm going to give you here is we're going to retard 1 degree for each gear. In second gear, go up to the map, pull the timing 1 degree. Double click on the third gear, pull that down 2 degrees. This will give you a total of 2 degrees in high gear. Once you do this, now we go to transfer, plot to MSD. This will send the data into the box, and now we're ready to race.